The blow-forward system for firearm operation is quite unusual in practice, although in physics terms it's fairly simple. The principle is that when the bullet is traveling down the barrel, substantial gas pressure has built up between the bullet and the cartridge case. The cartridge case, being brass, has expanded and formed a gas seal with the breech end of the barrel. In a blow-forward firearm, the rear end of the breech cannot move. It's being held in place by the shooter, and thus this gas pressure, if allowed to do so, is sufficient to push the entire barrel mechanism forward. Just as the weight of the slide in a blowback firearm slows its acceleration, so does the weight of the slide in a blow-forward system. This weight prevents the slide from fully opening until gas pressure has dropped to a point that it is safe to open. Historically, there have only been three firearms produced for commercial sale using this system. They are the Mannlicher 1894, the Schwarzlose 1908 here, and the Hino-Komuro. The advantages to this system are that it is potentially safer than a blowback system because there is no chance of the slide coming off the rear end of the firearm and hitting the shooter, as well as during that time period when the blowback system was still under patent protection, the blowforward system was distinct and different. The downside is that, somewhat counterintuitively, blowforward firearms actually create more felt recoil than blowback firearms. This is because recoil is the result of Newton's law, equal and opposite reaction. Recoil generated as the bullet travels down the barrel is reflected on the shooter. Similarly, if the slide is also moving forward, it is creating recoil of its own, which adds on to the recoil generated by the bullet and increases the total felt recoil to the shooter. Hopefully, this has answered some of your questions about blow-forward systems in firearms. I'm Ian McCollum for Forgotten Weapons. Thanks for watching.